The Thing Between the Trees, written by WybieLovat. We all know what I'm talking about. I don't know a single person alive who hasn't seen it before. You see it when you're driving, down the highway, past some decent cluster of trees. There, just for a second, you see a figure between the trunks. So brief that you dismiss it as your imagination or a fallen tree. And you know what? You're probably right. 9 times out of 10, there was probably an explanation for it. But there's that one time out of 10, where it was something. Sometimes you see it while you're on a hike. And how many times you see it really depends on what kind of person you are. If you are afraid or paranoid, you will see it a lot more. But it will always be there, just out of your vision. It lives in the corner of your eye. And no matter how many times you blink or turn your head, it will be there. To you paranoid hikers, I can tell you right now that it's your imagination. It doesn't care about those of us who are nervously cutting through the wilderness with a destination in mind. Whether that be a photo op at the top of a hill or a couple of miles of exercise, you are of no matter to the thing. No, the ones that it cares about are the people like me. The ones who love nature. The ones who take their time to try to become one of the creatures who call the forest home. The ones who walk places they shouldn't be. This is the story of my experience with the thing between the trees. This was years ago, and I've since moved to California. I was hiking one day, and I went off the trail. I wished that there was some rhyme or reason, but truth be told, I simply felt like going for a hike off the trail that day. I did it all the time, so it was nothing new. I lived at the very top of Washington, so close that I could practically walk to Canada if I wanted. About 5 miles up from my middle-of-nowhere town was a lake. Beautiful clear waters, a big green park right beside it. It was a pretty popular summer spot, but in May, there was only a couple of fishermen out. I set out with my backpack full of water and snacks, fully intending on spending the day in the green. Without looking back, I stepped off the trail and into the trees. It's a wonderful feeling to simply wander through the forest without a care in the world. No people to break the silence with words. Only the sounds of nature that humanity seems keen on drowning out. I may as well have been sleepwalking. I didn't pay a single mind to anything around me. Not that it would have made a difference if I did. I must have been about 10 miles out from the lake when I realized I had wandered into a dead zone. I don't mean dead plants or animals. I mean it was empty. A forest is full of life and sounds if you pay attention. But I looked around and I realized it was so eerily silent that I could hear my heartbeat in my ears. Not a single bird tweeted. No rustle of the wind between the branches of the monoliths around me. There was nothing. Nothing except the thing. I whipped my head to the side when I caught movement ahead of me. In the distance, off to the right. There, just past the trees, I could have sworn that I saw something move. I saw it again to my left, then again to my right. Every time I turned my head, I backed up one more step, further and further, back the way I had come. I don't know how to describe it, other than I knew that I was not welcome here. I needed to leave. I was standing in place, concentrating on the silence and scanning the forest for movement. waiting to see how far I needed to retreat. A quiet rustle of leaves to my left, just out of view, broke the silence. The leaves were so close, I knew something was right there, practically within arm's reach. I had to fight to turn my head as every fiber of my being screamed for me to run. I fought against the urge to run and turned, painfully slow. I saw the single most terrifying thing I had ever seen in my life. The thing no one hiking ever wants to see. I saw a small brown bear cub wander out from between some bushes. It looked up at me and froze, and I stared right back at it. As I stood there, frozen, the blood left my face and chills ran over my body, but I still couldn't move. I heard more branches break behind me as something approached, but still, I didn't move. I felt something breathe down the back of my neck. Something with breath so ice cold it couldn't have been alive. It sucked in air behind me hungrily, held it for the longest second that I've ever experienced, and then it screamed. It screamed so high-pitched and bone-chilling that it may as well have been the first icy wind of winter whistling through the trees. I finally moved. I ran. I didn't turn. I didn't scream. I didn't think about anything. Instinct took hold of my body and forced me to obey the oldest of all feelings, fear. I ran so hard my lungs hurt and my throat burned. And I ran. Sometimes I would see something off to one side, keeping pace with me in the distance, running between the trees. Whatever side it showed itself on, I would veer away from it. I ran long after I didn't see the thing again. When I finally slowed down and caught my breath, I turned back. I saw nothing between the trees. A couple of minutes after walking, I heard another scream. Farther away, but it kick-started my fear nonetheless. I broke into a sprint again despite the protest of my legs and lungs. I had slowed to a jog by the time I found my way back to the trail and allowed myself to walk once more. I went home after that. I can't say anything more eventful happened. The experience didn't turn me away from hiking or loving nature. But I am a bit more careful with where I travel when I go off the path, especially during bear season. But I'm not afraid of the thing, whatever it is. That creature or spirit saved me. You see, grizzly bears practically don't exist in the lower 48 states nowadays. The fact that I saw one was extremely rare. Grizzlies will leave you be for the most part, as long as you keep your distance. But not Mama Bear. She will do anything to protect her cubs. And if the cub was there, Mama wasn't far away. If she had caught me near them, I would be dead for sure. I am only alive because something screamed for me. Something out there was afraid for my life. Something out there wanted me to live. So now here I am. I think about the thing that screamed often. The sound still gives me chills when I think about it. But I know deep down that it was only trying to help. I wonder if that's all it is. A warning. Something out there trying to keep us safe. We're little more than babies when we wander through nature. The forest hasn't been home for humans in a long time. At the end of the day, We just don't really belong there anymore. It's dangerous. Maybe it's just looking out for us, protecting us from what we should really fear. Now I live in a small town in Northern California. Not nearly as small as where I was born, but plenty small enough to keep me sane. I can't stand the idea of living in a city. Why would I ever want to be away from the beautiful forest surrounding me? Every day I drive to work, I pass through plenty of forested areas, and I see it. There, between the trees as I drive past. Just for a second. Something watching the cars go by. I like to think it's checking up on me after all these years. I smile and wave every time, and I hope it sees me. I never did get a chance to thank it. So, I'll share my story, and hopefully, there will be a little less fear surrounding it. This is for you, the thing between the trees. Thank you.